the right attitude helps us occupy. We've been talking about possessing the promises of God, and we'll talk a little bit about what are the right attitudes that will help us step into and occupy God's promises. And then we'll talk about the attitudes which will keep us away from receiving the full blessings of God. So the right attitudes would be that of courage. And we see this in the life of Caleb. Now Caleb is said to have had a different spirit because he perceived things with God in the picture. So Numbers 13:30, then Caleb silenced the people before Moses and said, "We should go up and take possession of the land, for we can certainly do it." And so when everyone else saw that they would not be able to occupy, Caleb is someone who had the courage, because it would take courage to face the giants and then go and occupy the land. So Caleb demonstrated courage, and we too need courage to possess all the promises that God has for us. You know, there were a couple of other things that we can see in his attitude, and plus, you know, the attitudes that some additional ones that we need to have to possess the promises. The second one would be desire to subdue the enemy. Now Caleb had this. Caleb said that, yeah, we can easily get the enemies. And do we have that kind of an attitude when we face the challenges that Satan brings opposing us? You know, are we saying that, yes, through the power of the cross, I can face this. I am a child of God in Christ Jesus. You know, I am blessed with every spiritual blessings. I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. You know, are we those who can say, believe this truth and then face the enemy with that truth in our hearts? You know, a desire to subdue the enemy is very, very important. Being fearless when we face our enemies is essential. Being fully obedient to God and trusting in God, this will enable us to move into our territories and possess them. And this is an example which Caleb set for us. And so he was the one along with Joshua who walked into the promised land. Numbers 14:30, "Not one of you will enter the land I swore with uplifted hand to make your home, except Caleb, son of Jephunneh, and Joshua, son of Nun." So even before they walked in, you know, it was already God's desire to send in people like Caleb and Joshua who were courageous. And today I believe God wants each one of us to be like Caleb and Joshua, to fight the enemy fearlessly and be courageous and full of faith. And that's how we're going to possess the promises of God. Now, the book of Hebrews talks about all the others who never made it to the promised land. And here are some attitudes we never want to have. So what are the wrong attitudes that these people had? You know, they were full of unbelief. They doubted if God could rescue them and if God could help them dwell in the promised land. They neglected, though God had promised all these borders all to the children of Israel, they neglected. They never took a step forward, and they were also hard-hearted. Every place they went, they were complaining, and they only had to talk about what they didn't have rather than all that God had blessed them with. And so the book of Hebrews tells us, don't be like the others who never made it to the promised land because of their unbelief, because of the way they neglected the blessings of God, and because of the hard-heartedness which they carried. And so may we stay away from such attitudes. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you, O God, that you want us to walk in the fullness of all that you have given us. Thank you that your word declares that we are blessed with every spiritual blessing, O God, in the heavenly places. And I pray that, God, by faith, we will walk in those blessings, O God. Nothing short, Father God, of all that you have already delivered into our hands. Lord, we thank you and we praise you, Lord, that you cause us to enjoy your blessings. In Jesus' name we pray.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.